If you guys do have any questions on the way up, don't be afraid to throw them out there. My name is Jesse. I'll be your operator. It's going to be about a 5.5-6 minute trip. 3/4 of the way up, whenever we pass the tower, you guys are going to feel a little bit of a swing. I'll remind you when we get up there. As always, keep your eyes posted into the woods. You never know whenever some wildlife might pop up. Things. If you guys look out over there, you can actually make out some of the glaciers. The restaurant up top gets its name from that. Seven Glaciers restaurant is named that, being as how you can see seven glaciers from it on a good day. Each one of those valleys where that snowpack gets really rugged looking, those are actually glaciers. There's five that reside over there in that little range. There's one that's on the back side of it, and then there's one that sits inside of our mountain. Over here is the turning it on. That's part of the Cook Inlet, which is also part of the Pacific Ocean. It got its name from Captain James Cook's crew whenever they tried to sail through there in the late 18th century when they were looking for the Northwest Passage. It's also home to the second largest tidal fluctuation in North America. The only place that beats us is the Bay of Fundy off the coast of Nova Scotia. Ours fluctuates about 35 feet between low tide and high tide. So when it goes out, it looks a lot like that. A bunch of silt beds, a few little channels of water. When the tide comes back in, it very frequently brings in what they call a bore tide. It can be anywhere from a 6-inch to about a 6-foot wall of water that rushes through there. It covers everything up real quick. It's kind of like a little mini tsunami. People go out there and surf and kayak and paddleboard on it and whatnot. Then you got this side of the mountain, we call it the North Face. It's actually one of the longest consecutive ungroomed double black diamond ski runs in the U.S. My personal favorite side of the mountain. Of course, middle of winter, all this stuff you see is covered up with snow, except for the top halves of the extremely tall trees. You got a picture of about a 100-inch base on it at any given moment. That is the North Face hiking trail. It's about 2.2 miles with all the switchbacks. Whenever it's opened all the way to the top, as it stands right now, you are allowed to hike up until this point right here, and then you have to take out a spoon line. As you can tell, they came out and dug the little trench. So you guys are going to feel a little bit of a swing whenever we pass this tower coming up, just so you know. You may want to hang on to something or someone with better balance than yourself, or both. They actually opened this place in the early 1950s for skiing. We didn't have any chairlifts here in the very beginning. The only way you could get to the top of the mountain was either helicopter rides or hiking. As far as I understand it, the helicopter ride ran you $5. And then in 1960, then in 1960 we installed the first chairlift, which is that guy right over there. It's no longer usable to this day. As of January 1st, we had to stop using it. We can't insure it anymore. It's hit its life expectancy. It's more aesthetic now. But it did actually used to run into the building that sits right in front of it. That's called the Roundhouse. It was the very first structure put in up here. It's a historical landmark. It's been up here so long. In the top floor of that building is now the Roundhouse Museum. It's got a nice little bit of history about the mountains, surrounding valleys, some pretty cool videos, a little topographical map of the area. Pretty cool to check out. And just so you guys do know, this one is pretty much going to turn around and leave right off the bat. So, I mean, we do run every 15 minutes, so 5:45, 6, 6:15.
What's the last one?
1 o'clock in the morning. The last one up is at 9:30 tonight. We run every 15 minutes, no matter what, to get anybody off the mountain. If you go upstairs to the right, you're going to have the restrooms, a little observation deck, and then the roundhouse museum. It's also got a nice little deck that goes all the way around. It's a pretty cool place to get 360 view. Above us is the Seven Glaciers restaurant. You can get there by using the left set of stairs, left-hand side of the door, or you can use the Seven Glaciers elevator underneath there on the left-hand side. And you're more than welcome to walk around on the mountain. Just make sure you're wearing appropriate footwear. Keep in mind it's uneven surfaces. Please be careful and please don't hike up the mountain. Thank you.